In this video, we are elevating our editing skills to a new level. Up to this point, we've mastered sequencing clips linearly, one clip after the other. And you can do most of your editing projects like this. But now we're venturing into the creative realm of overlaying footage and utilizing advanced tools like masking. These techniques open up a world of possibilities, allowing us to craft more intricate and visually captivating stories. In this lesson, we will focus on a specific example, creating a split-screen comparison to showcase dynamic motion shots alongside their behind-the-scenes recording. Overlays allow us to add multiple elements to our footage, such as additional video clips or images. Let me show you how this works. So now let's open CapCut and let's start a new project. Here we're gonna change the folder. Our goal now is to showcase some of the clips that we shot in the adventure park and also the correspondent behind the scenes. So we're gonna take the first clip and then the correspondent behind the scene. Second clip and correspondent behind the scene. Then third clip and correspondent behind the scene. And so on and so forth with all the remaining ones. Then when I selected all of them, I'm gonna tap on add. So right now my sequence is composed by the shot itself and the behind the scene of that shot. But I don't want to have one after the other. I want to have the behind the scenes on top of the final clip. And to do so, we're gonna use a function called overlay in CapCut. To do so, we're just gonna select the behind the scene shot. Then we're gonna drag the menu towards the left until we see overlay. And then we're gonna tap on overlay. As you can see now, this clip is now on top of the main timeline in a new track. And now you can position this clip anywhere you need in the timeline. In our case, we need it to have on top of the first clip. So we're just gonna drag it and move it towards the left. And now we need to sync the two clips. There is not an automatic way to do so, so we just need to do it manually. So first of all, we're gonna move the overlay footage on the very top of the screen, just like here. So now our goal is try to match one single point of the top clip and the final clip as well, so that they match. And in this case, I'm trying to see when she touches the floor after a jump with the left foot. And it's probably gonna be right in this moment. Boom. So I think now they are synced. We're just gonna make the overlay clip as long as the first one, and then we're just gonna double check that they match. Now we have the two clips synced, but I can see that the behind the scene is in horizontal footage and is a bit too small. So maybe I wanna make it bigger. We're gonna select it, and then with two fingers, we're just gonna make it bigger, just like that. Then we're gonna reposition it so that we see the center of the action on top, just like that. And now I need to also reposition the final clip below because I want to see Hannah. So it's probably gonna be right there. And let's double check whether we like it or not. Okay, let's just trim the end of this clip right here because afterwards he goes down and he's gonna give us some headache. So we keep it like that, that's it. Then we're gonna move on to the following clip. We're gonna tap on it, then we're gonna scroll in the menu until we see overlay, and then we're gonna drag the clip underneath the other one. There you go. Now we have it on top. And the problem with this one is that it's a vertical shot. So right now there is no way that I can see also the final clip below this. So now we need to mask this clip. Masking provides precise control over how different video layers interact. This technique can be used to highlight specific aspects of a scene or blend clips creatively. In this case, I just want to see the action of the videographer. So with the mask, I'm going to remove everything that is around it that it's not necessary so that I'll be able to see the final clip below. So to add a mask, we're going to select the clip. Then we're going to scroll the menu until we see mask. You're gonna tap on it, and here you'll be able to choose among different masking options. Let me show you what they do. If we tap on horizontal, we'll be able to see only the top part of the footage. And if you move the circle that you see on the center with one finger, you'll be able to move the mask and decide which part of the footage you want to affect. If you drag this icon down, you'll be able to have a softer transition between the masked area and the clip underneath. And the more you drag the icon down, the more feather you're gonna have. For our clip, we're gonna leave it right here. Then using two fingers, you'll be able to rotate the mask as well in case you need a different angle. But again, for our case, we're gonna leave it at zero. If we had to pick this mask for our clip, we would just rotate it just like that so we can see the videographer's action. The other way on how you can adjust the position and the feather of a mask is just to tap on adjust. And here you'll be able to change again the position on the X axis, Y axis, and then rotate and also add more feather. Now let's tap on the check mark. Then in the menu below, we also have different masking options, including circle, rectangle, heart, and also star. So you can have fun with all the different options that you have. Let's select the mirror masking option because this will allow us to select a portion of the clip that we want to use. So in this case, I just want to have this middle part right here where we see the action of the videographer. Then when I'm happy with the masking, I'm going to tap on the check mark. And then with one finger, I'm going to move this overlay on top of the screen. Just like that. Then I can move also the final clip a little bit below so that I can see the action in this portion of the screen. Now we need to sync the two clips. And once again, we need to do the same process as we did before. Just try to find one single point in both clips and try to sync them. So now we need to just trim the final clip. And I want to give you a tip here. So now we position the playhead before the BTS clip, and then we're gonna tap on it. This will bring the playhead on the first frame of the tapped clip. So now we need to select the final clip. We're gonna split, select the beginning, and delete it. As you might have noticed, when you split or change the duration of the clips in the main track, the overlay clips do not move. So in this case, we just need to drag the overlay clip at the very beginning, just like that. And by doing this, we'll be able to maintain the sync that we did at the beginning. Now, I just want to trim this clip right here so that it finishes together with the final clip that we have on top. And now we should be good. There's just one thing that I noticed right here. The horizontal line dividing the first two clips is not in the same position than the horizontal line dividing the second two clips. This is because I had to do it manually and I don't have a reference point. But now maybe I want to create this reference point so that moving forward, I'll be able to know exactly where to create the mask and where the BTS clips should stay within our overall frame. My goal now is to create a line between the two clips. Unfortunately, in CapCut, you cannot add a line, so I'll have to import an image from my camera roll and then mask it to create that line. So we're gonna go in the main menu and here you can tap on overlay. Then we're gonna tap on add overlay. Here you'll be able to access your camera roll and now we just need to find the yellow photo that I want. So let's find our album. Then we're gonna go into photos and we import this yellow photo. There you go, then we click on add. Now we're gonna make this one full screen, just like that. And then we're gonna go and find mask here. We're gonna tap on it. Then we're gonna tap on horizontal. And if you move it just with one finger, you'll be able to decrease the dimension of this mask, just like that. Then when you're happy, you're gonna tap on the check mark. And then with one finger, we can move this masked line right in the middle here. That's perfect. Now you can tap on this new element and then we can make it as long as the sequence. So we're just gonna drag the right handle until the end of the sequence. And then if we have extra, we'll always be able to modify and trim it. Now, as you might have noticed, CapCut created an extra track. So now we have the final clips, the BTS shots, and also the line, which shows us on top because we added it as a last one. In case you wanna move the level of these tracks, you can just tap on one of the elements. Then you're gonna scroll in the menu until you see layer. Now you can order the layers. You can tap on one, for example, and then as you can see, the line disappeared because it went underneath. the BTS shots that we have as a second layer. So now I'm just gonna press again on 2 because I wanna bring it forward. I wanna have it on top of everything else. Then I'm gonna tap on the check mark. So now we have a reference point and we need to double check whether the first 2 clips are matching on the masking point with the second 2 clips. So we're just gonna scroll until the second 2 clips. And as you can see now, we have the BTS shots that is a little bit too low compared to the line that we created as a reference. So now we need to adjust the second BTS shot. And to do this, we have 2 options. Either we select it and we move the overall clip a little bit upward, or we can also adjust the mask because all the masks that you create can be adjusted at any time. To do so, you're just gonna go into the mask menu, which is here. And now you can see that it appeared the mask that we created before. So now if you just want to adjust the mask, we're gonna use 1 finger to move it upward until we are just underneath the reference line that we created. And then if you're happy with the result, you're just gonna tap on the check mark. And now we just need to keep going with all the remaining footage. Now, there's 1 thing that I can do to improve this overall sequence, and this is maybe adding an introductory clip. So to add a clip, you're gonna tap on this plus icon. Then again, we're gonna select the folder that we want. As you can see in this folder, we have almost all the clips with the label added on the top left corner, which means that we already have them in the timeline. Apart from this one, which we don't have yet because I want to use it as the intro clip. So we're going to select it and we're going to add it. As you may notice, we still have the yellow line. We have all the overlay clips on top, but don't worry, we'll have to move them later. Now we're going to select this clip here. As you can see, this clip is horizontal, so I'm just going to use 2 fingers to make it as big as the screen. There you go. So now I just need to select the best part of this clip that you see in the bottom of the screen. Now we won't be able to bring this one on the very top because it's not an overlay, so you just need to select the best part right here, and then we'll have to move all the overlays. So we're gonna probably select this part right here. There you go. So we're gonna split it here and then delete the beginning and also delete the ending. Now let's double check if you're happy with this. Yeah, I think that's fine. Now let's start moving all the overlays in their correct position. So we're gonna drag this one, then we're gonna move it, this one, move it, then we can keep going. There you go. And now we can add some text at the beginning. To do so, we're gonna go into text, then add text, and maybe we can write behind the scenes versus final result. So let's write that. And I'm gonna leave a space because I want to add VS in the middle, but with a different style. Just like that. And then maybe we can change the font. We're gonna pick SQL. Then we're gonna go in styles, and maybe we can add a glow just to add some separation from the background. In black. That's it. Then we can drag this text at the beginning and make it as long as the first clip, just like that. Then we can add another text saying the S. This time we're gonna change the style and we're gonna pick this one right here, the preset, but then we can eliminate the glow because I don't want to have that. Then we can decrease the dimension of this just to have it small in between the text. And now we make this one again as long as the first clip. Now we just need to add a music. And again, I selected already something that I like. So I'm gonna go into audio, I'm gonna go into sound, then folder, device, select from device, select Oceanside, and tap on open. Then we can import it in our timeline. Now I just wanna make sure to match the drop of the music with the beginning of our edited sequence. So basically excluding the intro. So we're gonna place it right here. I think that looks great. And we're gonna make it as long as the intro as well. Then I want to mute all the clips because I don't wanna hear background noise. So we're gonna tap on mute. Then we can also add a fade in into the music. So we can tap on the music, then we go in fade, and we drag the fade in slider to just maybe have it for 1 second and no more than that. Tap on the check mark and let's review the whole sequence together. You might notice that we can still hear some background noise. And this is because we muted all the clips, but only on the main track. So we need to go in the overlays and then mute each single overlay manually. Now, I just wanna show you one thing. Now we see the track of the music and we don't see the overlays anymore. If we go in the main menu, now we can see that we have some orange lines, for example, where we place some text. And we also had some red lines where we place some overlays. Plus, we can see these icons, and if we tap on them, we'll be able to access all the different levels that we have with overlays. So we're gonna tap on them, and boom, now we see all the overlays back. Then if you wanna hide them again, you just need to go in the main menu by tapping on this icon right here, once and twice, there you go. Now we are in the main menu. So we're gonna go in the overlays level, then we're gonna pick the first one, we're gonna tap on volume and drag the volume to zero. And then we're gonna do the same thing with all the other clips. Okay, now let's review the overall sequence again together. And that is our final sequence. This lesson has shown how to enhance your video projects in CapCut with advanced techniques like overlays and masking. By integrating these features, especially through our split screen example, your videos can achieve a new level of depth and engagement. Continue experimenting with these tools to discover more creative possibilities. Happy editing, and I'm gonna see you in the next video. This video gave you a sneak peek into what our iPhone Video Editing Academy has in store. Delve deeper into mastering advanced video editing techniques, from initial cuts in the Photos app to creating sophisticated scenes in CapCut. Whether you are a beginner or looking to up your video editing game, this course equips you with everything you need to make your project stand out. Join me as we explore the art of video editing, ensuring your content captures the essence of your creativity. Are you ready to elevate your editing skills? Check out the full course through the link in the description. I'll see you there.